Hello everyone, and we have some news from the world of rhythmic gymnastics. In this video, I will tell you what is happening with gymnastics in Uzbekistan and what happened to the gymnastics palace. Who and how congratulated the head coach of the Russian national team on her birthday, about the research in the field of the work of coaches with athletes, and other interesting news. And before starting the video, do not forget to subscribe to the channel if you have not already done so. And just in case, check your subscription. The subscribe button should be gray. Now a huge number of online tournaments are taking place on the internet, and every day there are more and more of them. Therefore, online tournaments are no longer something special. But I was attracted by a very interesting tournament, which I want to tell you about. It takes place online, and it's not just one start, but it's a whole league. Gymnasts have been competing with each other for several months. So the league consists of 6 stages. Each stage takes place once a month, starting in July. Gymnasts send videos filmed in the gym, at home or on the streets. The tournament is organized by the sports club Bagira from Lviv, Ukraine. Gymnasts from different countries take part. Also, in addition to the first, second and third places, the organizers highlight other nominations, such as Miss Choreography, Miss Dance, Miss Skills, Artistry, Flexibility and Shape. So this is a whole competition consisting of several stages. In addition to the competitions, masterclasses are held for the athletes. On July 30th, the head coach of the Russian national team, Irina Vinarusmanova, turned 72 years old. On her birthday, she was at a training camp with the gymnasts, where she organized a party in honor of her birthday, which was attended by the gymnasts of the Russian national team and other countries who were at the training camp at that moment. From the celebration, apart from the photos, there is a lot of material with congratulations that has been published in the media and on the internet. There, the gymnasts of the Russian national team congratulated the head coach in video format, and the main TV channels talked about Irina Alexandrovna. Alexandra Soldatova on her Instagram said that she was visited by doping officers who came to take some samples. According to the rules, athletes performing at the world level must always keep abreast of doping control, where they are, and can come to them at any moment to take a sample for analysis. And here it is, a living proof. The officers came to Sasha's house at 6 a.m. in the morning. The veteran sister, Dina and Arina, were recognized as the best graduates of university named after Lesgaft. The girls graduated with honors this year. In addition to their studies, they managed to be active in social and sports events of the university. In Uzbekistan, the fight against coronavirus continues. In the capital, Tashkent, it was necessary to re-equip the rhythmic gymnastics sports complex into a hospital for patients with COVID. The temporary hospital has 750 beds and has already started working and accepting patients. The gymnasts of the Uzbek national team are now forced to train at home or online. The team is coached in group exercises by Ekaterina Pirashkova, who shares on her Instagram how their trainings go. The topic of violence continues to gain power around the world. For example, a study was conducted in Australia on the impact of violent behavior on puberty. The study touched upon the question that in gymnastics, such growing up is considered something bad, which has a bad effect on the career of the athletes. Gymnasts who continued their careers after puberty began to train more consciously and responsibly. And the older the gymnast becomes, the more she listens to her body and can negotiate with the coaches for healthier trainings. Such a behavior helps to maintain a career as long as possible. In cases where this does not happen and the gymnast does not reach the end of maturation due to abuse from the coaches, athletes often end their careers due to strong pressure from the coaches. The result of the study was that it was necessary to restore the sport and its original ideology, when the relationship between the coaches and the gymnasts were not offensive. Also, Australian researchers call for coaches themselves to change their work with athletes when they become older and more trusted. So adult gymnasts will be able not only to fully train, but also by their positive example, they will be able to help the young generation to cope with the difficulties that they face in sports. Adults and experienced gymnasts, if they are not kicked out by the national teams because of their age, will be able to benefit the national teams, as well as make the sport longer and older. According to the Australian scientists it is necessary to strive for such a development? Write in the comments what do you think about this study and how do you think it is necessary to follow their recommendations. Well, that's all for me for today. Remember that I love you all, and for now, goodbye. The video was translated and dubbed by Alexandra Sinica.